Hi friends, welcome back to CADable, and today I'll show you how to calculate mass of an object in SolidWorks. And this is one of the questions which was asked by one of my subscribers. And let's go to new. And first of all, I'll create a very basic part in SolidWorks. And let's change my background. Let's go to, say, front plane, and go to rectangle. And let's say this dimension is 150 millimeters, and this dimension is 250 millimeters, and here are the units, right? MMGS. And let's go to feature, let's go to extruded boss. In fact, I'll add some fillets, and let's drag all these, let's change it to 15, right? Now I'll go to features, and let's change it to 100 from the mid plane. Select OK. Right. So this is my geometry, and now I have to calculate its mass. Right. I'll go to evaluate, and I'll go to mass properties, and here it is showing that the mass of this block is 3,730. Right. SolidWorks, right? I haven't choose any material, but SolidWorks is giving me mass, because SolidWorks by default chooses 1000 kilograms per meter cube density, right? If you want to calculate your mass, mass of the object, so you have to choose material every time, right? Here it is showing that material is not specified, so I'll go to edit material, and let's say I'll choose stainless steel, and here it is showing the properties of that stainless steel. The mass density is 8027 kilograms per meter cube, and let's say this cast is stainless steel, and the material, the properties are different. Let's say I want to apply this galvanized steel. Apply and close. So here you can see that the texture or the color of that block has changed, right? Now I'll go to mass properties under this evaluate, and here it is showing that the mass of this block is 29,360.5 grams, and the volume and the surface area, all the properties. Let's say I want to calculate the mass of that block in kilograms, right? So I'll go to options, and I'll go to use custom settings, and I'll change that unit to, let's say, kilograms, and let's say per unit volume I'll change it to meter cube, right? Let's say here is the meter cube. Okay, and now you can see that the mass of that block is almost 29.36 kilograms, and the density is 7870 kilograms per meter cube. Right. Let's say I want to change material, go to edit material, and let's say I want to apply some wood material. I'll go to wood, and I'll select oak. Here properties have changed. You can see that the mass density is 560 kilogram per meter cube. Apply and close, and you can see that the texture or the material is changed. Right. Here it is showing the shadow. You can off. Let's go to mass properties, and here you can see that mass has changed from 29.36 kilograms to 2.09 kilograms because of the density, right? Here is the one very important thing. Let's say if I want to apply appearance from this, and let's say I want to apply appearance, go to metal and polished steel, right? And here you have to remove that, remove material, and go to polish tape. Here you can see that the texture or the appearance has changed, and if I go to mass properties, and here it is showing that the density is 1000 kilograms per meter cube, because SolidWorks by default chooses 1000 kilograms per meter cube. So if you want to calculate mass of your object in SolidWorks, So you have to apply material, not appearance. If you want to render your object or your assembly, so you will go to appearance and you will have to apply some texture or some material from that appearance. But if you want to apply calculate mass or some mass properties, so you have to apply that material, right? Let's say copper. And if I go to this box mass properties, now I can choose that mass in my calculations, right? So this is a very big difference. If I want to calculate mass, so I have to choose material, not appearance, right? And if I want to let's say render my object, so I go to usually I go to appearance, right? So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you liked it, and if you have any questions, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. Thank you.